Namaste everyone, myself Bijal Parmar and I am here to turn your maths confusion into solution. Let's learn something about exponent and powers today. So first of all, what is exponent? So a repeated multiplication of same number can be defined using exponent, right? If same number is multiplied by so many times, we can define that number using exponent, right? Here I have written an example for you. 3 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3. Look, it looks so long to write, right? So we can write these numbers like this. 3 raised to 5. It is called 3 raised to 5. We can see here 3 is 5 times here in the multiplication. So the power of 3 will be 5. Now this 3 is called base and 5 is called power or exponent of the given number, right? Now whenever there are very large numbers and those are difficult to read, understand and compare to any other number, we make them easier using exponent, right? So that we can compare or read that number easily. So many of the large numbers in the shorter form, hum usko shorter form mein convert karke likh sakte hain. I have written some examples here. 10,000, we can write 10,000 like this. 10 multiply 10 multiply by 10 multiply by 10. So it will give us 10 raised to 4. The power of 10 is 4 here because 10 is 4 times multiplied here. One more example is there. 243. If we write all the prime factors of 243, we will get 3 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3. Means 3, 5 times. So we can directly write 243 as a 3 raised to 5. The power of 3 is 5. Now let's solve some example of exponent. The first question given here is find the value of given numbers, right? We can see here 2 is written with the power of 6. It is called 2 raised to 6. So we can know do like this. 2 multiply by 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 2. Means we have to multiply number 2 6 times because it has power 6. Now we have to multiply this number. 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8, 8 2's are 16, 16 2's are 32, 32 2's are 64. Now this is our answer. Right? The same way we will solve second example. It is 5 raised to 4. Right? So we will multiply number 5 4 times. It will give us answer 5 5's are 25, 25 5's are 125. And 125 5's are 625. So our answer will be 625. Second type is expressed in the exponential form. They have given us in the multiplication form. We have to write this number in the exponential form. So we can see here 5 is 2 times here. Right? So we can write like this. 5 is 2, 2. Here 5 is base and 2 is power or exponent. We can see the 7 is also given 3 times. So we have to write that also. So multiply by 7 raised to 3. This is the exponential form of given numbers. Here second example is also given. A multiply by A multiply by A. A is 3 times multiplied here. So it is A raised to 3. B multiply by B. B is 2 times multiplied here. So B raised to 2, or we can say B square, A cube. C is 4 times multiplied here. So C raised to 4. This is our exponential form. Third question is like that. Express the numbers using exponential notation. So first of all, we can see here 512. The question is given. First of all, we have to find the prime factors of the number. And then we can write it in exponential form. So let's start. see here 2 is at ones place, so it is even number, so it can be divisible by 2. If we divide 512 by 2, we will get 256. Again, this can be divisible by 2, we will get 128. Again by 2, we will get 64. Again by 2, we will get 32. 32 divided by 2, 16. 16 divided by 2 will give us 8. 8 divided by 2 will give us 4. 2s are 4 and 2 1s are 2, right? You can see here so many times 2 are there. So it is written like this: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right? So we will write 2 multiplied by 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 2. Right? 9 times 2 are there. So we can easily write this number as 2 raised to 9. Right? This is the exponential notation of given number 512. There is one more example given here, 64. Let's solve it. As we can see here, at last there is even number. So we can divide this number by 2. So it will give us 32. Again by 2, it will give us 16. Divide by 2, 8. Divide by 2, 4. Divide by 2, 2. At last, divide by 2 by 1. Right? So we can see here we got 2 6 times. So 2 multiplied by 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 2. But we can write this number easily as 2 as base and 6 as power, 2 raised to 6. Right? Thank you. Now let's see how to solve exponent given with different numbers. I have written an example here. 2 cube means 2 raised to 3. So we have to multiply 2 3 times, right? One more number is there, 5 square means 5 raised to 2. We have to multiply 5 2 times. Now, we have to multiply all these numbers to get our answer. So, 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8, 8 5's are 40, and 40 5's are 200. So this is our answer, right? One more example is that 3 square means 3 raised to 2. So 3 multiplied by 3. One more number is there, 10 raised to 4. We will multiply 10 4 times. It will give us 3 3s are 9 followed by 4 zeros. Right, it is 90,000. Okay, here negative numbers are given. So whenever we are multiplying negative numbers, we have to take care that if we multiply negative number 2 times, our answer will become positive. And if this negative number will be multiplied 3 times, 5 times, or 7 times, means for odd numbers, right? For odd times, so the number will remain negative only. As we can see here, minus 3 raised to 2. So we will multiply minus 3 2 times. And minus 2 raised to 3, we will multiply minus 2 3 times. Right? So 3 3s are 9. But this number 3 is 2 times here, right? Minus 3 is 2 times here. So the answer will become plus 9. Same way, 2 is also negative number. 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8. But you can see here, 3 is multiplied odd number of times, right? 3 times. So the answer will remain negative. Okay? So our final answer will be 9 8's are 72, but minus 72 will be our answer. One more example. Minus 3 raised to 2, minus 3 multiply by minus 3, we will multiply minus 3 2 times. Minus 5 raised to 2, we will multiply minus 5 also 2 times. Right? Okay. So 3 3s are 9. We can see here both numbers are negative. So answer will be positive here. Here also 5 5s are 25. Again the answer will be positive, because whenever we are multiplying two negative numbers, the answer will become positive. And 9 25s are 25 9s will be 225. So 225 will be our final answer. Numbers in exponential form obey some rules. So let's see law of exponents. I have written some rules here with examples. First rule is that if the base are same and between them there is a multiplication sign, we can add the power of the given base, right? So a is equal a raised to m plus n. I have written an example here. Here you can see base is 2 here, also here also, right? So there are same base given. So we can add the power of both the base. So 2 power 3 plus 4, it will give us 2 raised to 7. Second is, if the base is same and there is division sign between them, we can subtract the power of the given base. So a raised to m minus n. Let's see example. 5 raised to 6 divided by 5 raised to 2. We can see here both the base are same. So we will subtract the power of the base, because it is division sign here. So 5 raised to 6 minus 2 will give us 5 raised to 4. Third, when the given base has two powers, right? Power of power. Look here, a raised to m raised to n, right? So we will multiply both the powers. A raised to m multiply n. Let's see example. 7 raised to 3 raised to 2. Two powers are there, so we will multiply these two powers. So 7 raised to 3 multiply by 2. It will give us 7 raised to 6. Okay, now whenever the base are different, right, but the power is same, at that time we will multiply both the base and the power will remain same. Look here, 5 raised to 2 multiplied by 3 raised to 2. You can see here both the bases are different, but the power is same. So first of all we will multiply the base, so 5 multiplied by 3, and we can write 2 as a power. It will give us 15 raised to 2, or 15 square. Same way, if base are different and the power is same and there is division sign here, we can write like this, a divided by b whole bracket raised to n. Example, 6 raised to 3, 3 raised to 3. We can see here both the bases are different and there is division sign between them. So we can write like this as a fraction, whole bracket raised to 3. Okay, now if any number is having power 0, the value of that number becomes 1, right? Here I have written an example. The 5 raised to 0, the power of 5 is 0. So the value of any number which has 0 as its power, the value of that number will be 1 only. Next, if any negative number is given with even number of power, right? So the answer will become positive. And if any negative number is there with odd number of power, the answer will remain negative. See example here, minus 2 raised to 4. If we multiply minus 2 4 times, we will get 16 as answer, but 16 is a positive number. Minus 2 raised to 3, right? It is odd number of power. So 2 2's are 4, 2's are 8, but the answer remain negative, right? I hope you have understood all the laws of exponent properly. Now let's solve some examples using law of exponent. Okay, in the first example, the question is 3 raised to 2 multiplied by 3 raised to 4 multiplied by 3 raised to 8. We can see here all the bases are same and there is a multiplication sign so that we can add given power. So 2 plus 4 plus 8, right? So our answer will be 3 raised to 14. If we add this power, it will give us 14. Next example, 2, 2, 2. We can see all the bases are same. In the first bracket, there is a division sign, so we will subtract the given powers. So we will write like this: 2, 20 minus 15 multiplied by 2 raised to 3. Now, if we subtract 20 minus 15, our answer will be 5 multiplied by 2 raised to 3. Now you can see here, both the bases are same and there is multiplication sign. So we will add the given number. So 5 plus 3, it will give us answer 2 raised to 8. One more example. You can see here all the bases are same. And in the first, there is power of power, right? So we will multiply the powers. So 2 3s are 6 multiplied by 5 is 2 4 divided by 5 is 2 7. First of all, we will solve this number because it is in the bracket. So there is multiplication sign and both the bases are same. We will add the given powers. So 6 plus 4 divided by 5 is 2 7. Our next step will be 5 is 2 10 divided by 5 is 2 7. Here both the powers are different, but both the same bases are same and there is division sign. So we will subtract the given powers. So 10 minus 7 will give us 5 is 2 3. Okay. Now we can see here all the numbers are different. So how to solve this? So let's see. 2 raised to 3, 3 raised to 4. This 4 I can written as 2 square, right? Because 2 square is also 4. So we have to make the bases same. Here 3 and 32 can be written as 2 raised to 5, right? Now in this numerator, both the bases are same, 2 and 2, so we can add the given powers. So 2, 3 plus 2 multiplied by 3 raised to 4. In the denominator, 3 multiplied by 2 raised to 5. Right? Now in the next step, 2 raised to 5 multiplied by 3 raised to 4 and 3 multiplied by 2 raised to 5. We can see here both the numbers are same, so we can cancel both the numbers. So our answer will be 3 raised to 4 divided by 3. But we can see here both the bases are same and there is no power here, it means there is 1. So both the bases are same and it is in division, so we can subtract the given power. So 3, 4 minus 1, so our answer will be 3 raised to 3, means 3 cubed. Now let's see how to write a given number in the expanded form using exponent. Okay, 279464, the number is given to us. Now we have to find the places. It is 1's place, it is 10's place, 100, 1000, 10,000 and 2 is at lakhs place. So we can write like this: 2 multiplied by 10 raised to 5, because 2 is at lakhs place, so 10 raised to 5 will be lakh, right? So we can write like this: 2 multiplied by 10 raised to 5. Plus next number, 7 is at 10,000's place. So we can write like this: 7 multiplied by 10 raised to 4, because 10 raised to 4 is 10,000, right? Next number, 9. 9 is at 1000's place. So we can write like this: 9 multiplied by 10 raised to 3, because 10 raised to 3 is also same as 1000. Next number 4. 4 is at hundreds place. So 4 multiplied by 10 raised to 2. 6 as tens place. So 6 multiplied by 10 raised to 1. And 4 is at ones place. So we can write like this, 4 multiplied by 10 raised to 0. So this is the method to write expanded form using exponent. The same way we can solve the given exponent powers and write the numbers. We can see here, first number is 8 multiplied by 10 raised to 4, means it is 10,000's place, right? So first of all we will write 8 at the 10,000's place. At 1000's place, 10 raised to 3 means it's the 1000's place. So at 1000's place the number will be 6. 10 raised to 2 means it is 100's place. So at 100's place we will write 2. At 10's place it is 4. And at 1's place it is 5. So our answer will be 86,245. Now this is our last topic of this chapter. If the number is so large, we can express this number using exponent very easily. Here we can see that 5 is followed by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 zeros, right? So we can write like this, 5 multiplied by 10 raised to 7, okay? Now whenever the number is given, first different numbers are given, then it is followed by zeros. At that time, we will keep first number as it is and then we will use decimal to express the given number. So it will be 3.1865 multiplied by 10 raised to, how many numbers are there after 3? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So power of 10 will be 9. I hope you have understood all the topic covered in the exponent power. I have attached one assignment for you. After this video, you can solve these questions given in the assignment. Thank you.